say up front that there is no way that I can cover all of the things that are important to you. And so if I don't cover some of these things that are important to you, please know that my cell phone number, my direct cell phone number, is on my business card at the front table, and you can call me anytime to talk about something that's important to you, or to say, Jacqui, I felt like you completely missed something that was really important. So I'm going to do my best to cover the things that I see as important, but if there's anything you want to talk about, I'm here to talk about it. I'm going to ask the river kids to hold the mic for me.
State and
federally recognized advocate for our St. Lucie River Indian River. I have traveled to Washington, D.C. and Tallahassee many times. I am proud to say that the River Kids, can we come up here? I am proud to say that the River Kids started here in the town of Sewall's Point when I was there in 2011 and 2012. For over 3 years, I have written a blog every day on the subject, including the Indian River Lagoon, land development, and history of our area. I know this subject through and through. I know the recent scientific research regarding cyanobacteria, which is toxic algae, and it's linked to ALS and Parkinson's disease. The health of our rivers is not just a property value, wildlife, and quality of life issue, but more importantly, a health issue for our community. Septic conversion, water farming, and area canals are all important parts of the water puzzle. But a third outlet and reservoir south of Lake Okeechobee to redirect these waters as nature intended away from our rivers is imperative. I am in a position to work towards this goal with background, determination, and intelligence. Number three, civility. Our Martin County Commission District 1 seat is in dire need for more civility. Civility is about disagreeing without disrespect, about seeking common ground as a starting point for dialogue about differences, and about not throwing your fellow commissioners under the bus. I am a trained University of Florida meeting facilitator, one of 20 state leaders chosen by the University of Florida in 2015. I'm part of class 15 of IFAS's Natural Resource Leadership Institute. Wow. Myself and others from state agencies, people that we don't always see as our friends, the Army Corps of Engineers, the water districts, the Florida Wildlife Commission, farmers, tribes, law enforcement, elected officials, and county employees, travel together once a month to study our state's greatest conflicts. Whether it's putting a spaceport in the middle of the National Wildlife Center, Wildlife Refuge, waterboards causing the fishermen of Apalachicola to lose their historic livelihoods, or the collapse of the St. Lucie River, Indian River Lagoon, we learn how to analyze situations, facilitate conflict, and seek collaborative solutions. For years, Martin County has had a reputation for being polarized and thriving in conflict. When I am voted into office, I will offer a balanced and civil approach to local politics, listening not just to my fellow citizens, but also to my fellow commissioners. While my speech is coming to an end, and we all know that there are serious issues other than the ones I've mentioned facing Martin County. All aboard Florida, the county redevelopment areas, expansion of the city of Stewart, and maintaining our urban service boundary, state growth that is expected to go from 20 to 26 million by 2030, affordability in housing, 50% of the children in Martin County being on free and reduced lunch, beach renourishment, including minorities at the table of decision making, dredging the St. Lucie Inlet, the future of Indian Town, fire rescue services, Costco, the future of our parks and public golf courses. In an age of declining revenue, we really have to rethink these things. The airport, widening of roads, the list goes on and on. Most heartfelt to me is really the relationship between the county and the municipalities. And for those of you who are not elected officials, this may be something that's hard to understand. But for that small group of people that are elected officials, we understand. And if you don't have a respectful, good relationship between your cities and your county, you've got some problems. And we have really got to work on these things. And I think that would be one of the most, that is something that I would like to work on and try to help improve. Environment. They will not be solved with disdain. There must be a new way of thinking. There must be more collaboration and civility. I am the face of that civility. I am you. Grassroots team, you are all my grassroots team.